you're not your feelings, and you are not what you're thinking. To be gauges, but not primary data. Our emotions to report things to us. So the body is sending information to the soul. The second mode of information or source of information or source of this coming to it is our spirit. Your soul is getting information as a believer from the natural world and the spiritual world. And many times they don't line up. Right? So your spirit, the Holy Spirit in you, the Spirit is working with the Word. That's why it's important that you get in this book. Why? Because God, the Spirit of God and the Word work together. So the more that I have in me, the more the Holy Spirit can pull up for me. So the more I have in me, the more the Spirit can pull up, right, can pull up into my soul. If I don't know what the Word says, all of a sudden here comes the information from the realm of the senses, the body. If I don't have any Word in me, what happens is the Holy Spirit there's a block there. He's trying to pull things up, but it's not there. I'm not saying that God can't speak to you as Christian. I'm not saying that. But whatever you've got in you, because John 14 says the Holy Spirit is going to bring things back to your remembrance that He has said. He's going to bring things back to your remembrance. You guys are word people in this place. My God, you finish scriptures for me all the time. You don't get that everywhere. You guys got the Word in you. Think about it. I mean, you guys, I can start off a scripture and get four words in, and you can finish off the rest of it. You're word people. But the Holy Spirit is working and wants to pull that up into your soul. Why? Because there's conflicting information being given to us. So the soul, I got to know that the soul is receiving information from different places. Okay? Again, I'm saying, you are not what you feel, and you're not all the time what you think. So if you have a rogue thought, quit getting in agreement with the rogue thought. That's why, what does the Word say? Right? If you're experiencing anxiety, you're experiencing anxiety. I don't deny that. But you are not the anxiety. You are a child of God that has peace on the inside. That's what the Bible tells us. I can sit and observe it, I see it, I feel it, I understand it, but I'm not that. Now, there's much we could say about all that, about peace and all these things, but I just want you to know where it's coming from. Number three, real quick, slow down. How do you do this? How do we do this? How do we steward our emotions? Slow down. Slow down. What do you mean slow down? Remember what James said? He said, let every man be what? Swift to hear. Slow to speak, and what? Slow to wrath. When you start feeling your emotions starting to take over, slow down and ask some questions. And if we all just do this, we'll all be better off with it. When you start feeling your emotions starting to take over, I need to ask some questions. Slow down and ask why. Why? Why am I like this? Why am I getting emotionally charged? Most generally, we get emotionally charged because we have fear. Fear, anger especially, comes out of fear a lot. Right? People getting angry and have uncontrolled anger. There's something deeper that's cooking. What's the fear? It's not all of it. I'm just saying, what's the fear? Many reasons why people get angry. I'm just saying. But asking questions, why am I feeling this way right now? If I'm feeling anxious, slow down and ask. Okay, hold on. Why am I feeling this way right now? What am I thinking about? Where's my mind? What's consuming my thoughts right now? what has been consuming my thoughts today? I'm not saying it's going to solve every issue. I'm just saying it could go a long way for you and I controlling our thoughts. Slow down, right? And ask some questions. Number four is this. Last one. We need soldiers. We need soldiers. Listen, hear what I'm saying. I'm closing on the plane. If you're having a problem with soul control, let me help you. Check what you're listening to. Check what you're reading. Check what you're focusing on. If I'm having a problem with my soul, right, I need to check up of what I'm feeding into my soul. Now, this is where God's Word comes in. This is where God's Word starts to come in. I need to get to start feeling. Now, you say, well, Pastor Paul, I've done that, and anxiety hadn't left. I understand that. But I'm still placing myself in a position, right, that I'm putting the Word in there, right? I'm changing my focus away from whatever it is. Sometimes we can't identify it. I understand that. There's lots of things we can talk about. I'm not a counselor, but I know there's lots of reasons why people experience that. But I'm saying generally, if we'll take a moment and we'll say, listen, what is feeding into my soul right now? 2 Timothy 3:16 and 17 says, all Scripture is inspired by God and is useful to teach us what is true and to make us realize what's wrong in our lives. It corrects us when we're wrong, teaches us what to do, teaches us to do what is right. God uses it to prepare and equip His people to do every good work. God's Word has power in it, guys. I need you to hear that. God's Word has supernatural ability. It's been infused with the very breath of God. This Bible is amazing. It's a library. Wrote over 1,500 years. A little over 40 different authors. And they all wrote about a Messiah. They all wrote about redemption. They all wrote about that. It's supernatural. And when I begin to read the Bible, I am not even concerned about how many chapters you read. I'm saying, listen, if it's one word from God can change your life. But I guarantee you one thing. You keep putting the Word in you, and you keep putting the Word in you. All of a sudden, what begins to happen? The Holy Spirit has something to pull up. You may not remember chapter and verse, but you know it's in there, and you got it. There's a gist about what you're saying. Your problem doesn't need to hear chapter and verse. Your problem needs to hear the power of God's Word and the confidence of God's Word coming out of your mouth. The enemy doesn't care whether you know Hebrews 4:12 or whatever. You've got to be a revelation in your heart and you've spoken out of your mouth. And when that stuff in your soul is starting to become a problem in your life, just like it has in my life many times over the last 28 years of my life, being born again, I've had soul control. Come on, problems with that, right? Things have come on me. Things have tried to bombard my thought life and my thinking and my emotions have got out of whack. What do I got to do? I got to stand up with an answer. I got to answer with the Word of God because the Word of God is truth. Jesus, you will know the truth and the truth will make you free. I got to believe it, man. I got to believe it. There's only one thing that will truly change your thinking. That's the Word of God. And that's why the Bible says, Paul said, he said, I beseech you therefore, brother, by the mercy of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service, and don't be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Renewing of your mind. Apostle Paul said this in 1 Thessalonians 2:13, the Amplified, and the Christ. We also especially thank God continually for this, that when you receive the message of God which you heard from us, you welcomed it not as the word of mere men, but as it truly is the word of God. Look what it says, which is effectually at work in you who believe,
exercising his superhuman power in those who adhere to and trust in it and rely on it. God's word has power to change your life. Let the word of God dominate our minds. Amen. Let it dominate our minds. And when God's word is dominating our minds, it will dominate our lives and thinking. So this is why I'm closing with today. Don't second your emotions. Don't second it. There's a song about that. Right? Don't second your emotions. Let them be the caboose. Let your faith be the engine. If we don't manage our emotions, they will manage us. The success of our Christian life is the stability of our emotions. God doesn't want you an emotional mess. God's not giving you the spirit of fear, but of what? Power, love, and what? A stamina. You have a stamina. So, Pastor Paul, you know what I'm going through right now. I get it. You're not in your feelings. What's your confession? I have a sound mind. Well, don't feel like I have a sound mind. Doesn't matter. The truth says I have a what? Sound mind. So what do I need to do? I need to respond and I need to answer whatever it is that I'm feeling with the Word of God. That's why I need to get in the book. Right? I need to know what God says. That way I can speak what God says. And if I can speak what God says, right? Well, what about speak that thing 900 times? Speak 901. I don't have an answer why somebody's not getting delivered or why you have it or why. I don't know. I don't know what God's word says. And we got to get set on that. Amen. Now, listen. There's multiple ways God can bring deliverance to you. Leverage every tool you got, leverage everyone. But know every good and every perfect gift, it comes from where? It comes from above. Amen? You guys all right? So, stewarding your